Hey everybody, it's Drogeth here with game number 3 between Snurtle as the red Protoss player in the upper right-hand corner and Rio as the teal Zerg player in the lower left of the Steps of War map. The matchup between these two is 1-1 in the InterStarCraft Cup European. Well, it's InterStarCraft number 3 tournament, which took place in Europe or on the European servers. And on the last matchup, Rio was able to overcome overwhelming odds from Snurtle with a series attack that he pushed in on, and he actually right on the expansion from Rio, he put force fields on the ramp so that no forces from the main could come down and stop him. However, the Rio Zerglings were nowhere in the main, were actually outside the base, and were able to come in and very easily surround Snurtle's attacking forces, thus eliminating them, and then rushing into his base. Now, he could have eliminated him a lot earlier by rushing past the Zealots in the front, as they were not on hold position, so they did move out a little bit, but he could have rushed in, destroyed the mineral line, and gotten in some serious pylon damage before even encountering a single Zealot, but the attack was drawn out quite a bit, as Snurtle, with his expansion right to the, his natural expansion right to the south of his base, was continuously pumping out probes, though not enough to really give a viable income for defending such an attack. By the end of it, stop laughing at me, honey. My wife's laughing at me. By the end of it, Snurtle was overcome just by the sheer number of Zerglings that Rio was able to produce. We do have the spawning pool coming down. Looks like a 14 pool that went down. Income-wise, Snurtle is doing slightly better as he has been. Oh, nope, check that. Rio and Snurtle neck and neck with the income. However, looks like there are no gas resources for Snurtle going down. No Vespene gas for him. But as we've seen, as the game goes on, Rio tends to forget to make more drones and just continually make his buildings, and he even forgets to build more once he gets to his expansion until he finally does. Rio dropping down extractor instead of doing that cancel move, taking this extractor, preventing Snurtle from doing a two gas push unless he goes into his expansion or takes that out. However, we do have Zealots streaming across, gonna try and cause some type of damage. Rio, on the other hand, dropping down a spine crawler for defense, expecting some type of early Zealot pressure, as Snurtle has been doing some very good pressure with the Zealots in both games. Now, let's see, do we have a chrono? We do have the chrono boost for the Zealot coming down. This long rush distance, having a nice rally point right up here, so gonna get enough Zealots. However, Rio reacting perfectly fine with his two spine crawlers back here. However, I would like to see him teching up a little bit harder than this, knowing that these Zealots are going to be coming out. These Zerglings just won't be able to deal with it. Getting to that Roach very quickly to deal with these Zealots would definitely have been the smoothest move to do, since the metabolic boost is going down. However, Snurtle chasing Rio back into his base, gaining early map control and speed enhancement. Look how fast those guys are moving on that creep. And we have the speedlings coming down. Will they be able to handle 1, 2, 3, 5 Zealots? Yes, no, we'll find out soon, hopefully. I'd like to see some action going on, but we do have the warp tech going down. 10 more Zerglings coming down for Rio. And still just sitting here waiting, allowing Snurtle to amass several more units. Looks like Rio's trying to catch him out of position. However, the longer he waits, the more Zealots that Snurtle can get, and that will just be painful. Again, Rio is not going for the Roach Warren. He should have gone down for the Roach Warren again to take out these Zealots more handily than amassing speedlings would have been able to do. Snurtle moving his units over here, getting rid of that extractor so that he can go up on gas. And look at that, Snurtle going right for the Twilight Council. Something that I thought he should have done quite a while back in the first game. He actually didn't do it until right the very end. but that is something that he should have done right away, not catching those zealots out of position. They're actually walled off right there. So he can, actually, with the curve that he has right there, Ryo can get several 1-2, probably 2 zerglings on each of these zealots, especially with those speedlings in there. And he could even bring the queens over here once that surround's done to do some damage. That even more so, he can do some damage to those front line. But again, he's doing this nice little wall. He's actually holding position right there. And Ryo is just kind of sitting back waiting for his lair to come out. Even more zealots coming down. Zealot charge is not going up. However, we might be seeing it go right now. Right now. No, we don't see it going. We have a Templar Archives going down. Snurtle, you don't tech off one base that quickly. Going for the charge would have been enough to warrant whatever you were doing on there. And definitely... I don't know. You guys kill me. Maybe I should pick a different mat. But one zealot coming in, testing the water, seeing what's going on around here, and being taken out very easily. Not fast enough to move in. Again, these zerglings not really doing much. These queens coming over, probably get it. This creep spread is a good idea, though. It's always a good idea to spread your creep. Is these queens the 1-2 queen? And especially these spore crawlers coming over here to cause some extra damage to those zealots. However, that is a little bit too close, as those guys take quite a while to go. And look at that, they're bearing down and Snurtle is not moving. He's going to be taking some serious damage from these guys as soon as they land. Look at that. And he's running back, a couple of stalkers there, nice pylon going down there. Expansion going down. Okay, so with that map control and the tech already in place with the Templar Archives, the expansion going down, he will be able to have the gas for that tech. And we have some nice little combat going on over here, an Archon being formed. Very nice. Causes extra damage to bio units. So, getting the Templar into the Archons beforehand, or just warping them right in. Again, do not see a Roach Warn. Roaches doing good against all these zealots. The Speedlings doing good against these Stalkers. Neither of those units doing good against the Archons unless the Archon gets surrounded. But again, Ryo just sitting back and basically letting Snurtle build up his forces so that he can push in however he likes to. However, looks like he does have some mutas coming up. We do not have charge going down yet. We do not have Psystorm going down yet. We don't have the Caden amulet going down yet. So, really interested in seeing why Snurtle is teching up so hard without even doing anything as far as the resources to handle all that. These mutas, 1, 2, 3, 6 mutas coming up, trying to get on the backside of an attack. Nope, just kind of looping around and coming in. Here we go. And look at that. That Archon just absolutely devastating those Mutalisks, and these Speedlings coming in, getting a nice surround on those Zealots, but actually pulling out. I don't know why they pulled out. They had a nice surround on those Zealots, as you can look at the health of those Zealots going down. These Mutalisks are going to get taken down very quickly by the Archons and the two Stalkers. Three of them had gone down just then, and here come the Speedlings again. These Archons, the Speedlings not getting good surround on these Archons. The Archons able to do the extra damage to the Speedlings, just double-shotting them with that splash damage, Mutalisk going down, and now Snurtle can afford to push into the base. Still, I don't see any tech going down from either of these tech buildings. It looks like they're just there for the Archons. No type of tech. Archon, 24 kills altogether. Okay, 12 and 12 kills altogether. Looks like Ryo's kind of laughing at his misfortune of the of all the kills that Archon is getting. But okay, so these Archons were a good idea to get right away. However, if Ryo had pushed out, had gone to the Roaches right away to take care of these early Zealots before the Stalkers had come out, it would have been a completely different story. Oh, look at that. The Archons is actually bending the vision around the creep. It's like they have an extra force field around them. Look at that. They're actually bending stuff like a heat wave. That's kind of cool. Anyways, some Psystorm finally going down. Close combat attack going down finally. We don't have any more mutas coming down. We do have a second hatchery and a Roach Warren finally coming down, although it is a bit late for the Roach Warren going down. Snurtle putting down an expansion right here in the gold to the south, the southern gold on Steps of War, and he does have, look at that, 6 gateways. He's got all his tech up. He's got plenty of resources, so he is doing the heavy tech now that he is at a huge advantage over Rio, slowly pushing into the base. Look at all those Archons over there, and they should just be able to rip apart whatever they come into contact with. Anything bio is just going to be going down. And even the Speedlings know they need to keep away. And here we do Roaches coming in, trying to cause some damage. These Archons not being surrounded, but doing some nice damage to all these organic units. And it is just a wrecking ball of glowing blue light. Just look at this, absolutely coming in here, destroying Roaches, destroying Zerg, and Rio quits very quickly as he knows he's lost Game 3. So that was Game 3, Rio lost, and we will see Snurtle going on to, let's see, the round of 4 matches. So look forward to seeing some of those. This is Draugith checking out.